Hello and welcome to another episode of Speed, short, powerful episodes of enthusiasm and determination. I hope you're enjoying these episodes and I appreciate you tuning in. Today we're reading from Stories from the Heart, sent in by lots of people. Lovely stories. Let's read one. I think you'll really enjoy this, actually. He was in the first third grade class I taught at St. Mary's School in Morris, Minnesota. All 34 of my students were dear to me, but Mark Eklund was one in a million. Very neat in appearance, he had that happy-to-be-alive attitude that made even his occasional mischievous delightful. Mark also talked incessantly. I had to remind him again and again that talking without permission was not acceptable. What impressed me so much, though, was his sincere response every time I had to correct him for misbehaving. "Thank you for correcting me, sister," he would say. I didn't know what to make of it at first, but before long, I became accustomed to hearing it many times a day. One morning, my patience was growing thin when Mark talked once too often, and I made a novice teacher mistake. I looked at Mark and said, "If you say one more word, I am going to tape your mouth shut." It wasn't 10 seconds later when Chuck blurted out, "Mark is talking again." I hadn't asked any of the students to help me watch Mark, but since I had stated that punishment in front of the class, I had to act upon it. I remember the scene as if it happened this morning. I walked to my desk, very deliberately opened the drawer and took out a roll of masking tape. Without saying a word, I proceeded to Mark's desk, tore off two pieces of tape and made a big X with one of them over his mouth. I then returned to the front of the room. As I glanced at Mark to see how he was doing, he winked at me. That did it. I started laughing. The class cheered as I walked to Mark's desk, removed the tape and shrugged my shoulders. His first words were, "Thank you for correcting me, sister." At the end of the year, I was asked to do junior high maths teaching. The years flew by, and before I knew it, Mark was in my classroom again. He was more handsome than ever and just as polite. Since he had to listen carefully to my instruction in the new math, he did not talk as much in the ninth grade as he had in the third. One Friday, things just didn't feel right. We had worked hard on the new concept all week, and I sensed that the students were getting frustrated with themselves and edgy with one another. I had to stop this crankiness before it got out of hand. So I asked them to list the names of all the other students in the room on two sheets of paper, leaving a space between each name. Then I told them to think of the nicest thing they could say about each of their classmates and write it down. It took the remainder of the class period to finish the assignment, and as the students left the room, each one handed me the papers. Charlie smiled, and Mark said, "Thank you for teaching me, sister. Have a good weekend." That Saturday, I wrote down the name of each student on a separate piece of paper and listed what everybody else had said about that individual. On Monday, I gave each student his or her list. Before long, the entire class was smiling. "Really?" I heard somebody whisper. "I never knew I meant that much to anyone. I didn't know anyone liked me so much." No one ever mentioned those papers again. I never knew if they discussed them after class or with their parents, but it didn't matter. The exercise had accomplished its purpose. The students were happy with themselves and with one another again. That group of students moved on. Several years later, on returning from vacation, my parents met me at the airport. As we were driving home, Mother asked the usual questions about the trip, the weather, my experiences. There was a slight lull in the conversation. Mother gave Dad a sideways glance and Dad said, The Ucklands called last night. Really? I said I haven't heard from them for years. How is Mark? Dad responded quietly. Mark was killed in Vietnam. The funeral is tomorrow, and his parents would like it if you could attend. I've never seen a serviceman in a military coffin before. Mark looked so handsome, so mature. All I could think of at that moment was, Mark, I would give you all the masking tape in the world if you would only talk to me. The church was packed with Mark's friends. Chuck's sister sang the battle hymn of the Republic. Why did it have to rain that day? It was difficult enough at the graveside. The pastor said the usual prayers. The bugler played taps. One by one, those who loved Mark took their last walk by the coffin and sprinkled it with holy water. I was the last one to bless the coffin. As I stood there, one of the soldiers who'd acted as a pallbearer came up to me. Were you Mark's maths teacher? He asked. I nodded, and I continued to stare at the coffin. Mark talked about you a lot, he said. After the funeral, most of Mark's former classmates headed to Chuck's farmhouse for lunch. Mark's mother and father were there, waiting for me. We want to show you something, his father said, taking a wallet out of his pocket. They found this on Mark when he was killed. We thought you might recognize it. Opening the billfold, he carefully removed two worn pieces of notebook paper that had obviously been taped, folded, and retaped many times. I knew without looking that the papers were the ones on which I had listed all the good things each of Mark's classmates had said about him. Thank you so much for doing that, Mark's mother said. As you can see, Mark treasured it. Mark's classmates started to gather around us. Charlie smiled rather sheepishly and said, I still have my list. It's in the top drawer of my desk at home. Chuck's wife said, Chuck asked me to put his in our wedding album. I have mine too, Marilyn said. It's in my diary. Then Vicky, another classmate, reached into her pocket, took out her wallet and showed her worn and frazzled list to the group. I carry this with me at all times, Vicky said, without batting an eyelash. I think we all saved our lists. That's when I finally sat down and cried. I cried for Mark and for all his friends that I would never see again. What an amazing story. You never know when you're making a difference in someone's life. You just never know. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for listening. Have a fabulous day. Bye-bye.